Hello guys and welcome back. So for today I have a small vanity unit and I have to install it in a cloakroom. I have everything here, so I just need now to unpack everything, put everything together right here in this room, and then we are going to go and install it in the cloakroom area. Alright, so here is our unit. I will just have to install the taps and the waste. I will have a pop-up waste in this case, so I'm just going to start by installing those. Okay, so I have my tap here. And I'll just start to install this one. I'm just going to install the flexibles. You can see they have a washer right here at the top, so you don't need to put anything else. You just need to screw them in and you are going to tie them up just with your hands, no tools, as much as you can. And that is going to be our first step. Then in the pack we have two bolts here. I'm just going to put these now in, just inside here. All right, so I remove these because I don't need them from now. These are going to go from the back of the sink. Now we are going to have a rubber washer and a metal holder. These are just going to go on the pipe like that, with the washer on top, but from the back of the sink. So before we are going to go at the back, I will just need to insert this support here that is going to stay on top of the sink. Also going to have a rubber washer that is going to stay on top of the sink, and that is going to help with the water not passing through. Okay, and we are done with that one. Now we just need to insert the flexibles inside the sink. Okay, and now we just need to turn it, and at the back . All right, so now we can close it down. I'm just going to put the washers and to insert them here. And now I'm just going to tighten everything up. Just want to make sure now that everything is nice and straight before tightening it completely. So make sure that everything is nice and straight, and now I can tighten everything. Now it's very handy to have one of these tools here. These are for monoblock tap from Rotenberg, and it's a spanner set, and it's going to help a lot with this type of jobs. Now I'm not going to go crazy with tightening it up too much because I don't want to crack anything. So now next step is going to be the waist. And this one is quite simple. So before going forward and install the waist, I'm just going to put a little bit of silicone all around. And that should be enough. And now we just have to tighten it from the back. Rubber washer first. Okay, so I'm not going to go crazy on this one. I just done it with my hands. If I will still need to tighten it up, I will do that at a later stage with my wrench. So right now, next step is just going to be the handles that are right over here. And let's just install those. They usually come like that, so the handles are going to be at the back of the door because they don't want nothing to be scratched during the transport. So they usually come installed at the back of the unit. And that's it, really. Now the unit is ready to go in the cloakroom, and we are going to hang it on the wall. Exactly here we are going to have the brackets. We need to drill some holes, and now and after everything is going to be nice and stable, because at the moment it's just going to drop down. just need to place the vanity unit in the desired place and just mark the holes of the vanity onto the wall. So after we transfer that, we just need to drill and then connect. Plugs for the screws to go, and they are in. Now we have our original black brackets that it came with the vanity unit, and I'm just going to put those in. That is done, both sides, and now we just need to do all the connections for the sink. Okay, so here we are inside the cupboard, the vanity unit, and we can see that my flexibles are not going to reach the pipes. So in that case, we can make it the easy way. We can do it the easy way and just connect another pipe, another flexible, to the flexible that is going to the tap, and then we can connect it in. Now we are just going to take this off. Okay, so then it's going to be very easy to connect it. More or less like that. Of course, you have to tighten it up, see how is the best for you, for the flexibles to go. And that is one of the options that you have. That is the easiest way. It's going to be on the surface right here, so you can see it, just in case it has leaks or something like that. But I'm going to do it differently. It's going to be a little bit more complicated, and I'm just going to put some copper pipes inside here, and I'm going to make it a little bit longer like that. For that, I will need some compressions also, because those are going to come just here on top. I'm just going to take this one out, and then we can connect straight into the flexible like that, and I think this way is going to be a little bit more tidy. So I'm just going to tighten these ones up and tighten it also on my bolo fix, yeah, the shutout valve, and then I'm just going to connect the flexibles. So I'm going to quickly do that. And one is done. Let's do the second one. Don't forget the copper olive, and we can put it in Okay, so now everything is done. I just need to connect the hot and the cold. Now these flexibles, they have a washer inside with a filter. And you don't need to tighten it up too much. Like that, same here. Okay, so I think I just connect them wrong, because it's always hot on the left, cold on the right. And that is going to be the other way around. So this is going to be here. And that is going to be there. And that's it. Now I'm going to put them inside the clips. And yeah, make sure everything is tightened, not too much. I'm just going to do it just a little bit. With my wrench. Not too much, because we can cut the rubber washer inside. So that looks okay, and I will still need to do some connections for the waste pipe. Now I have this trap here, and I will need to also do some modifications on the pipe, because at the moment I cannot connect it. So I have this sleeve here. I already connected a piece of pipe. I'm just going to put it like that there, and a bend that is going to go like that. Maybe I'm going to cut it a little bit more. So I have my small bit of pipe here, and my bend, and then I need another small piece of pipe, which is going to go right in. And everything should go like this. Okay. So at this point, I'm going to take everything off again and start gluing everything. Here's some solvent cement. Now remember, this stuff is quite cheap, and just have to put a lot over there, because if you are going to get any leaks, it's going to be a little bit more expensive than this glue here. Okay, I will check it again. Make sure that everything is going to go like I want. And yes. Just need to put this rubber washer inside so we can connect it to the actual trap. Okay, and that is going to go inside there and inside here. So now all the connections are done. We just need to see if everything is going to be okay, and I'm just going to block the sinking, and I'm going to show you that at a later stage. Okay, so at this point we just need to open the valves and see if we have any leaks. Okay, so no leaks at the moment, so that means the hot and cold is okay. Let's check the trap, and I'm just going to open the trap. So everything is nice and dry. At this point I'm just going to take the trap out and I'm going to seal the sink in on top of the vanity unit. I'm going to use some silicone seal to do that, and we are going to be done in no time. Okay, so let's quickly do that. Okay, so right now I'm just going to put a bit of silicone right over here. It's going to be some clear silicone. So I'm going to do that even on this other side, but because I have everything connected, it's a little bit harder to move it. Thank you.
Okay.
I'm still going to seal it at the end on top, but I want some silicone inside it. That should be enough. Now I'm just going to press it in. And I'm going to take all that excess of silicone out. And that's it with the silicone for now. Okay, so finally we just need to put the covers from the brackets in place. And that is going to go like that. And we have another one here. And it's in. And then the shelf. And I think I'm going to put it around here someplace. And done. All right, so at this point our small vanity unit, it's fit for purpose, so we can use it now. All is working fine, not that difficult to install one of these. The only problem is you need to plan ahead, you need to have some bits and pieces that you might need when installing all the plumbing and the fittings. Alright, now on the last thing that I'm going to do onto this sink is just going to be a seal right next to the wall. So on top of the sink and on the wall, but that is going to block water going through. Even if I'm going to have that small bead of silicone at the back of the sink, I'm still going to put another one on top. But before I'm going to do that, I'm just going to wait for that to go off, and then I'm going to apply another one on top. All right, so at this point a very important thing to do before ending everything. Smash that like button and see you on the next one. Bye!